Hello and good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Rooster's Nest. My name is the Rooster, and every morning I go live right here on Bego and on YouTube to read to us all from this book called The Book of Awakening by Mark Nepo, because there is a beautiful insight for every single day of the year. It's very spiritual. It's very wholesome. It gets us in touch with our humanity and with our soul. It's beautiful. With the earth and the heavens, so that we might all have some peace in our hearts as we go about our day. Am I right? So that's why we do that every single day. And then after we do that, we read or pull a card from this deck called The Nature of Infinite Love and Gratitude. Ooh, gratitude. It's so important, gratitude. It's how we are going to manifest our dreams. So let's get on it. Grateful for everything, good and bad. It's all part of life, guys. There is a really lovely image of nature on every one of these 52 cards. And then there is a message as well. So we pick one at random, because then we know that it's for us on this day. And then we see what it is. We don't know what it's going to be. So it's exciting. Something new every day. Out of the 52, one out of 52 chance of getting what we get. And then after we do those two things, I perform in some sort of way. And I've decided I'm starting to do themed days. Today, since it's Thursday, it's a throwback day, and I will interpret that however I feel like interpreting it every day. So that's the show. And here we go. October 21st says, having honest friends. If you tell me you already understand, I feel a little pessimistic. If you say you do not understand, I feel more optimistic. Thich Nhat Hanh. It could be thick or Thich Nhat Hanh. Who said that. This Vietnamese monk, so renowned for his insight, helps us remember that no one can live up to their image of themselves. Hi, thanks for joining. Yeah, oof, whoa, that is a big thing for us to remember. Helps us remember that no one can live up to their image of themselves. Guys, we can only live out our questions. I have learned from both sides, from being the one with all the answers and from being the one with all the questions. Hello, Marcus Magliarella. We're reading from the Book of Awakening. That there is no real bond with others until we share the evidence of who we are and not. Hi, being human. Perfect. We need you here. Glad you're here. This is the Book of Awakening by Mark Nepo. It says that there's no real bond with others until we share the evidence of who we are and not just our conclusions. It's taken a long time, but I finally get it. I cannot have both truth and love in my life until I speak from the I and stop putting all my pain into you. Until I own all my stumblings and stop projecting my misfortunes onto everyone nearby. Hi, Chan Chandra. I have a friend. His name is Alan. We have known each other for 29 years. Across 18 states and through storms, we swore we would never let up. We held each other when marriages failed through accidents and cancer. We held each other up when our grandmothers died. I have seen him in the rain where words can't reach him. I have even seen the rain that is his alone. And here, now, because we've dared to open our small windows to each other, because we've broken down in front of each other with fragments of what we thought was truth, we have the privilege of asking again, as if for the first time, who are you? I look at him after all these years without protection and I say, I want to know you. Whatever you have withheld, whatever I have not been able to hear, let us sit in the clearing. Whatever I have not been able to hear, let us sit in the clearing. I already said that. And understand each other like old birds whose wings are used now more to huddle than to fly. That is so beautiful. It's having an honest friend, one before whom you can dump all your heart's pockets and still feel that you are worth something, is a form of wealth that will buy you nothing but will give you everything. Hi, Bisma. Welcome to my life. We're reading from the Book of Awakening. It's so beautiful. And mysteriously and rightly, to find such a friend, we must be such a friend. Yeah, baby. So good. So good. Okay, so that was our message for today. And how beautiful was that? So now it's our meditation time. There's always a meditation at the end of, there's always a meditation at the end of his paragraphs. So we're going to see what the meditation is today. Hello, Manan Kazimi. Okay, so it says this is a meditation around risk. Center yourself and breathe freely. Thanks, guys, for the taps. Center yourself and breathe freely. Bring to mind someone you would like to be closer to. Breathe deeply and recall a belief you have expressed to this person. Now meditate on the personal experience that led you to this belief. Being a fan. Hello there. We're doing a meditation right now. Breathe freely and safely and make a vow to share some of this experience the next time you are together. Okay. I vow to share next time. So one more time, I'll read it all to you, this meditation, I'll read it. It says, this is a meditation around risk. Okay, my friend, sounds good. Center yourself and breathe freely and bring to mind someone you would like to be closer to. Breathe deeply and recall a belief you have expressed to this person. Now meditate on the personal experience that led you to this belief. Breathe freely and safely and make a vow to share some of this experience the next time you are together. Okay. Sounds good, friend. Hello, Kat Kazen. Welcome to my live. My name is the Rooster. I'm a drag king, and I read from this beautiful book every morning. And then there's a meditation at the end of the reading. Anyways, that was our insight and meditation from Nepo today, and now we're moving right along to the nature of infinite love and gratitude. Ooh, gratitude. What's it going to be today, guys? What card is it going to be today? Hello, Mubu Mubba. Hi there. How are you? We're just about to pull a card from this deck of The Nature of Infinite Love and Gratitude by Dr. Darren Arnold Weissman. There are 52 cards in the deck, and we pull one at random every day to see what our insight is for today. Reminders. It's natural reminders from the universe. The universal pool of love. What's going to be today? Yeah, what do we got today? What's it gonna be today? What do we got today? Ooh, what's it gonna be today? What you got for me today? Let's see. Oh, what's it gonna be today? Oh, look at this. Oh, I love a fuzzy plant. This leaf is fuzzy, and there's a caterpillar on it. What's that? This leaf is fuzzy, and there's a caterpillar on it. It says intuition. It says, no matter which path I choose, being courageous, following my heart, and trusting my intuition keeps me moving. Intuition nourishes my soul to sing, it's time for my awakening. There's an exclamation mark there. So it's not just me being dramatic. 31. Number 31, which equals 4. Sorry, I got a hair just tickling me. No matter which path I choose, being courageous, following my heart, and trusting my intuition keeps me moving. Keeps me moving. Intuition nourishes my soul to sing. It's time for my awakening. Love. Yeah. No. The caterpillar. Beautiful. Okay. So now it is time for the performance part, which I feel like is not everybody's favorite part of the show. But I do it anyways, okay? It's at the end. So, like, you get the best part of it. And then it's like, if you don't want to watch a silly goofball dance around and sing sometimes, then you don't have to. It's Throwback Thursday. And I'm taking a song from my childhood, from a show that I used to watch as a kid. I'm gonna be super silly. Well, you know, it'll be silly. I'm not gonna give it that much. We'll see how it goes. Still coming?
Life is like a hurricane, year in, duck, bird, race cars, lasers, aeroplanes, it's a duck blur, my top a mystery, or rewrite history, Ducktales, woo, every day they're out there making Ducktales, woo, tales of daring, do bad and good luck tales.
I'm regretting not binding my boobs, you know?
When it seems they're headed for the final curtain, Ruby Ducks who never fails, that's for certain. The worst of messes become successes, Ducktales. Every day they're out there making Ducktales. Woo! Tales of daring, do bad, and good luck tales. Woo! Danger, watch behind you. There's a stranger out to find you. What to do? Just grab onto some Ducktales.
Every single day, they're making those Ducktales.
Good luck, ducktails. Woo! Ponytails or cottontails, no ducktails. Woo!
Yeah, I'm a huge goof. I wish everybody was a little more goofy, you know? It'd be a happier place for us all. Anyways, that's the show. Thanks for the taps. Thanks for watching the Rooster's show. I'm here every morning. So come on in. Remember, you can never fail if you never give up. Number two, everyone is. Thanks for all the taps, my dear. Everyone is someone. And the journey is, who are you? Listen to this tea insight. This tea insight from my tea this morning, Yogi Tea. It says, the purpose of life is to know yourself, love yourself, trust yourself, and be yourself. That's the purpose of life. So let's do it. Each of us individually need to do that. And number three, if you ever feel down, all you have to do is say, and the rooster will be with you. Take care. Thanks for being here. I love you. I'll see you tomorrow. Mwah. Bye-bye. Ah, yeah.